Okay, gaming news now. And when we found out that actor James Buckley was a massive gaming fan, we immediately put in a call to see if he wanted to come on the show. Yes, he said, as long as I can bring a mate and we can have a right laugh. Sounds fine to us, we said. So he did. Famed for his role in The Inbetweeners, James Buckley is also a huge gaming fan. And there's nothing that James likes more than a bit of retro gaming. He's even got his own YouTube channel.
Golden Axe is one of my all-time favourites.
Recently, Sega, Sony and Nintendo have been hard at work revamping their classic consoles. And to find out if they're as good as we all remember, we asked James and his best mate from school, Matt, to spend the day on a gaming bus playing them.
Check this out.
That is awesome.
It's a little baby SNES.
It's small, but it's packed with 21 classic games, including Street Fighter 2, Star Fox, and The Legend of Zelda. But today, the boys have gone for a certain Italian plumber.
You're gonna go with Mario?
Yeah.
No imagination. First thing I noticed, Matthew.
Sure.
It's how smoother and sharper everything looks.
Yeah, it looks great.
Unlike the original 1992 SNES, this classic mini plugs into your TV via HDMI.
I gotta say, it's a great little package.
It does look good, doesn't it?
Yeah. 21 games, all these years later, they still play well.
SNES success. Next up, it's time for some old-school Streets of Rage. Sega have recently launched a compilation of their Mega Drive classics that you can play on Xbox, PS4, Switch and PC.
Over 50 classic games, and there's a double-sided poster inside. Stick this in the Xbox, Matthew.
Oh, it's just like my childhood bedroom.
Look at this. Now, this is choice. So this was basically most games. It was just walking along the street and beating a load of people up and people trying to beat you up, but not actually knowing why. But again, it looks good, it's been updated, everything looks sharp.
It actually seems like it's displaying at a native resolution.
I was waiting for you to say something boring, Matthew. I knew you were going to come out with something boring in a second. Can't you just be happy playing Streets of Rage?
Power up for the Mega Drive. Time for our final mini console.
It's a tiny PlayStation. It's not a tiny PS1, which is what a lot of people call it. Can we agree on that, world?
Okay, James, we hear you. The PlayStation Classic comes with 20 games, but straight away, it seems the boys are a little disappointed with what's on offer.
Out of everything that we've done today, I think this is the worst selection.
There's some massive games on the PlayStation that aren't there.
Yes.
Tomb Raider, Crash Bandicoot.
But let's play some Cool Borders, shall we?
Okay.
The Classic is 45% smaller than the 1994 original, but it seems that's come at a cost for James.
This one isn't making me as happy as the other ones, that's for sure. So it does seem a little bit sort of fuzzier, as if the game's almost out of focus. For a console that is actually newer than the games that we've been playing this afternoon, it doesn't look as good as the other stuff we've been playing.
Not such a classic after all. So, what's the final verdict?
I think if I had to choose between the three that we've looked at today, Matt, I'd probably go with the Mega Drive game for the Xbox. 50 games that we had on that, and they were all really good games as well.
Ooh. Well, that was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, pretty good.
Coming to mine for tea?
Mum's making smiley faces.
Oh, my favourite.
Come on in.
Oh, you've got to love a smiley face, haven't you? And the guys seem pretty smitten with the Nintendo too. Let's have it a go, come on.
Oh, that was such a big one for you.